Hello friends, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whatever the time is for you. As from the recent videos, like most of the people were requesting, like, can you please make some particular video, like where you can show like how we can like use our ADSL or VDSL modems as a router only. Like if you have any spare modem, like previously if you have any Airtel connection and then you disconnected it, or like by somehow or some mean, like if you purchased FTTH and still you have your own router, then in this particular video I'm going to show you, like, if you really want to use just a modem only as a router, what steps you need to do. So first of all, as you can see on my screen, like on screen, if you can see, this is my current FTTH modem, fiber optical modem, like which is Huawei SG145V5, and this is Huawei 6HG633, which I was using as a VDSL modem. And you can see right now it's WLAN and the LAN light is blinking because I already configured to use it as a router, as a Wi-Fi router, whereas I connected it via the LAN, whereas I just connected LAN 1 to the LAN 4, or you can connect it to the any particular LAN. And so once it's connected, then you need to browse to your interface, which you can access by 1.1, and then because of the security certificate, just accept this so you can access the interface. And right now you just need to like log in with the credentials for your modem, which is normally admin or admin password. And once you are there, what you have to do, just only two changes. You need to click on the home network, then you need to go to the LAN interface, and if you see here this point, DHCP server, what you need to do, you need to disable this DHCP server. To make it only as a router, you need to disable this DHCP server. And in case if you already did this, right now you can see on the top the IP is 1.1, whereas the fiber optical modem IP is again 1.1. So we can't use the same IP range on both of the routers if we have to use it as an extender. So just change it to 0.1. And right now this particular router interface is 0.1, and now from now you can't access this particular router interface after making it just only a router. If you have to access that particular router, what you have to do, you have to just connect your LAN cable directly to your laptop, then you can access this interface. Just by Wi-Fi, no, because it is already in a bridge mode. So right now, but from now we can access 1.1 interface directly after connecting it to the router. You see, right now I just connected it to the particular Wi-Fi which was of my HG633. If you see the Techobia, both of the Techobia is visible to the lower, and I connected to the top one, and you see the internet is working. Let me show you some speed test, because there is some particular issue, like you can see some sort of a minor variances, because this HG633 is only capable of 100 Mbps to support the 100 Mbps, whereas if I'm going to run the speed test directly on a Huawei SG145V5, like which is a fiber optical modem, I am normally getting like 112, sometime 120, 122 Mbps, like on 100 Mbps connection. But in this case, I will never get more than 100 Mbps. So the speed will always lies between 95, 96, 98, 94. But as concerned to the Wi-Fi range of this particular router and the Huawei SG145, there's a difference. Like right now I am sitting almost 25 meters away, right? Whereas if I'm going to connect to this is just only for the additional information. I'm not sure like you really need this information right now or not, but in case if I'm just connected to the fiber optical modem, right now I am not able to access more than 40 Mbps on this particular modem, right? But via this router I am able to get 94 Mbps while sitting 25 meters away from that. So you can see what's the difference between Wi-Fi AC or whatever Wi-Fi chip they have, like what's the difference between them. So I also purchased a Jio connection. It is like providing, they are providing them the free connection of a 150 Mbps, so I already have a trial connection installed at my end. So most probably I will make some interesting videos on that, and you will see these soon. Up to then, bye bye, and please make sure as you people like my videos and my videos are helping. I saw a lot of the comments, but it's my request, if you really like those videos, just give it a like and please subscribe to the channel. So I assure people are really liking the videos, so it motivates me to make more videos for you people. Up to them, bye bye, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Take care.